Hey guys, Brian here. Welcome back to the shop. So the cylinder head off Old Yellow is set up here on the mill, and I'm ready to cut it for the fire rings. So this is what I got. It the closest match to the groove that's in there as I can get. And these are 118. So leave 62. So I shouldn't even take like 36 thousandths off his head to get the proper crush. I'll verify that, but it means it can take a pretty hefty little cut. But we're not gonna get crazy to begin with. Got a lot of interrupted cuts in here with these grooves and everything, so I guess we'll just take 5 off begin with and see what that looks like. Something funny going on with the setup. So I've got some compound angle action going on for put these ports in. How I do them. Don't have a 5-axis CNC, so we go Perkins style and just bore the geometry for the valve, then finish it off with a grinder, blend it in. So on this 5-9, it's got a lot of offset to the runner, so I got to do this funky angle in order to get the pocket through the valve pointing to the runner like it belongs. So I got four done, two to go. I figure I'll let you watch these last two. Maybe I won't screw it up. think that's a cylinder head worthy of Old Yellow. Not the original one that came on that truck, but the one that's been on there pretty much the whole time it's been competing, drag racing and whatnot. I did this head a long time ago. I actually Buddha Power did this head a long time ago. And I didn't even have a mill at the time. So, going back over all this, redoing it the way that I do them. Of course, you don't see stock heads much anymore. Most everything's an aftermarket casting, although that's kind of gone away here now, so I guess it'll become a lot more valuable. But if you want to get real serious, just go ahead and get a billet head. Forget it. Although a lot of places still require cast, depending on the rules. So anyway, it's just a regular old Cummins head, nothing special. But as you can see by the shadow lines, cut a lot of material out of those ports. So, should have picked up the flow on this head by quite a bit. And I'll just go in and blend out those witness lines in the corner. The port keeps going back there, so it's easy just to knock that off, but I can't go down that far or start getting into the guides. See, the witness lines are pretty much the same on all of them. So, fairly consistent casting, and I did a fairly consistent job on it. So, I'll work my magic, and this thing's ready to go back on the truck. I did forget something. When I had this set up here earlier, I need to run a 9/16 reamer through these holes for the 14 millimeter hardware. I don't have to get it super accurate for that. I won't have to index it in. I can just use the stop blocks and knock that out real quick and just be ready to go back on the truck. So, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. I'll catch y'all later.